When I consider Pilot watches or Flieger watches, there's a few brands that come to mind, and one of those brands is Laco. Hello, you're watching James. My name's James, you're watching me, and I'm talking about watches. And I'm today talking about a Laco Type B Flieger, a watch that I've seriously considered buying on many, many occasions because I really like the idea of this brand. I like the heritage that's associated with them. I like the quality that they seem to represent, and I like their pricing because I think with Laco, you can get watches from different price categories. And I like the fact that from a heritage brand like this that has so much links to this style of watch, that they are producing watches that are relatively affordable. Because if you like this particular watch, you can buy them for around about $500 Australian. And I really want to talk about that price in a little bit more detail, and I would like you to stick around to the end of the video to hear me talk about that, because I think it's partly important in regards to this video. Now, I didn't end up spending that money because I've ended up borrowing this particular watch. A big thank you again to Mark, a subscriber who lives locally to me, who has lent me a number of watches, and I'm really thank you because it's been so good to get hands-on with this particular watch. And if you're interested in seeing this one put side by side with perhaps a slightly more expensive watch, a Stoa, well, stick around to the end of the week, and that's exactly what I'm going to be doing too. But for now, let's flip the camera, let's check out this Laco. But then at the end, I'll come back to price. So this Laco Basic Pilot, the Type B Flieger, comes in an outer box. We've got some guarantee cards here, giving you 2 years warranty, some instruction manuals, and an internal box. But with this Laco, you get some stuff. You get a sandblasted case, a watch that is 42 millimeters. You get it with a sapphire crystal, a Miyota 82S0 movement. It has 50 meters of water resistance. It's made in Germany. And yes, it comes with that 2 year warranty. Now, Flieger watches end up being quite large, which is why this one is feeling large, but is not too large because the case itself is 42 millimeters. The height of the watch is 12 millimeters. The lug to lug is 49.5 millimeters, a nice lug width of 20. And on this strap, which I don't think is the original, it comes in at 86 grams. And when you take this watch outside, you see the blue sunburst dial, because when you are in the shade, this one almost looks black, but yes, when the sun hits it, that blue really stands out. And then when you look beyond that beautiful blue sunburst, you can see that we have a classic Type B Flieger, having the 5 around 255 with the upwards arrows, as well as the 1 to the internal 12 on the smaller sub dial down there in the center of the dial. The hands are black, and they are loomed, small little stubby hour hand, very long minute hand, and a nice long second hand. And as you look at the loom of this one, it is a bit of a standout feature. And I love seeing that second hand is also loomed. It really does glow. I'm really impressed. That is all covered by a piece of flat sapphire crystal. It's a nice enough piece of crystal. It actually sort of almost disappears a little bit. I think there must be a little bit of AR coating, because even when we put the studio lights on there, it is still fairly easy to see beyond that and seeing what the watch is actually saying. As you can see, just after 10 past 10. Now, the entire case, including the surround on the case back, is all bead plastered, and it has this really interesting color to it when metal is bead blasted. It comes off this really sort of like a shimmery silver gray, and it has this lovely tactile feel to it. I do like sandblasted watches purely so I can touch them like that and have that really soft feel to it. Crown there is like a semi-onion, it's like an angular onion. Only has 50 meters of water resistance, this one, so not a screw down crown, but we can go straight into manually winding. Now, the movement that's inside of this one behind this mineral crystal on the back of this watch is a Miyota 82S0, but it has a custom rotor which shows you that it is Laco and made in Germany. Now, of course, that movement is not made in Germany. That is a Miyota movement, but the watch itself has been put together in Germany. Being a Miyota movement, it means it is automatic, obviously. It does have that hand winding, but it does also have a ghost position, worth keeping in mind. But being this particular Miyota, it does have hacking. And I'm always interested to see how different movements are performing, especially ones like this, which I don't see all that often. So let's see how this Miyota is performing on my time grapher.
Now, I'm actually pretty okay with those figures, especially from one of these more basic Miyota movements. Running at 21,600 vibrations per hour, virtually no beat error, very healthy amplitude, and running about minus 10 seconds, well within the specs of this particular movement. And if this was my watch, I would be very happy with those figures represented there. And I have to say, when you're looking at that Miyota, it's actually quite a good looking movement. For a more of affordable movement, it's got a little bit of decoration on there, but it does have one of those winding rotors that only goes around one way. Now, I've only worn this watch a little bit because it is a borrowed watch, but I haven't noticed that sort of rotor feel, movement, or noise too much. So I think this one, it's not too bad. Now, I'm pretty sure this is not the original strap. I've been looking online and I've never seen one on this strap, and it doesn't have Laco written anywhere, so I'm not really going to talk too much. I think this one either comes on a bracelet or a light grey NATO. So they're the ones that you're probably going to be choosing between. And I would always choose the one on a bracelet so you can then go back and forth between other straps. But I think it is interesting to see a watch at this size on my 6¾ or around about 17 centimeter wrist, because it's really pushing the boundaries without going too beyond those boundaries. It sits down onto wrist quite nicely. The width of this watch, or the height of this watch, isn't too bad. It actually sits down okay. And being a pilot watch, it's meant to be a bigger watch. So for me, this size actually is quite good, because it's bigger being a pilot watch without being oversized. So what do I like about it? What don't I like? And what would I change? Well, firstly, I love Type B Fliegers, so that's going to be standing out to me. Plus, the lume on this one is particularly good, and I do like how they've done the hands, especially that second hand, a nice and long, almost delicate look to them. And I quite like the design of this crown. It's not too sort of vintage, and it's also not too modern, so it's a nice sort of balance between the two. However, I'm probably not super impressed with that sort of movement at this sort of price range. I think it's okay. It's not overpriced for a watch movement like this in this sort of price range, but I probably would prefer something different. And being blue is probably not my favorite with this particular style. I think it's nice and it's a beautiful blue, but it just feels a little bit wrong to me. And that's probably what I would actually change. I would like this within just the more traditional black. And I've just spoken about that price again. I've spoken about how I'm starting to feel about the price of this watch, and I want to go into that in more detail. And to do that, let's get back to me.
When I had personally considered buying a Laco on those many occasions, I thought $500 was the right price. I thought that's a fantastic price from a watch brand that has been around for so long, that has so much history with pilot watches. A watch that is being produced in a reasonable quality, because every review I'd seen them had said positive things about them, and that price range seemed right. And that was until I got hands-on with this watch. And I am not going to say it's a bad watch. I like this watch. I do. But I seem to have a weird sort of feel with it, because $500 for this watch is probably about right. It sort of feels like it should be $500, but I personally wouldn't spend that money on it. And the reason why is a little bit different to some other reasons why I haven't bought other watches. It's because I think with this one, I think I'd rather spend less money and maybe get one of those more affordable watches. Or possibly, as I ended up doing, spending more money and buying something that's a little bit more refined. Now, I know Laco has got more expensive watches available. I ended up not buying one of those watches because I had a bit of a feel that it might have that same feel to me. So that's why I ended up buying a Stowa. So this one, it's a little bit muddled. I'm possibly sort of saying it's a good watch, and I know people like this watch, I know people enjoy this watch, and I'm not saying that it's not worth the money. I'm saying that it feels okay at this price. But for me personally, I think I'd rather spend less and get a cheaper one, or spend more and get a more expensive watch. I hope that's not confusing. It probably is confusing. It's confusing for me, but at least I know now that I won't be adding one of these Lacos to my watch collection. But I want you to stick around this week, because I'm going to be doing the full review of my Stowa, a watch that cost a lot more. But then I'm also going to be doing a side-by-side and try and explain this a little bit more. But while we wait for those videos, maybe check these ones out next.